Hey, what's going on guys? It's Tikosaur, and in this video we're going to do something which is pretty cool actually. So I got this Legion Go mod case from AliExpress that is widespread by now. It's version 2, in case you are aware. The version 1 is this, and in States this one is the version 2. So actually I've got it and I was like kind of interested to try it out. So you could remove this SSD fat cover, and you could put a normal size NVMe. You could install it in the exterior part. This way you are not touching the battery area. And it also provides some air ventilation for the original SSD size that you can put in here. And some additional air ventilation to the back cover. As you can see, like, you have bigger holes for allowing better airflow. And also you have the kickstand, so we're going to check it out. So overall the build quality is totally okay. It's 3D printed, however, like, it doesn't look so high-end like the ones for the Ally. They have a higher quality overall than this mod case for the Legion Go. Now I'm not sure why the Legion Go isn't getting so much love like the Ally. So instead, in the meanwhile, we're going to check this one out. I'm going to compare the temperatures between the original back cover and this modded one, so in order for you to know if it's worth having or not. So first of all, let's remove the Joy-Cons. So we're going to remove the old one and change it with the new one. So in order to use the kickstand, we're going to remove the original kickstand mechanism and put it in here instead, because it doesn't come included with this one. So as you can see, the kickstand come unattached to anything. So we're going to use the original one because it doesn't come with any. So just for your info. So now just open the kickstand, and you will see another 3 screws that we'll need to remove as well. So we're going to use those hinges as well as their own screws for the kickstand mechanism. So yeah, you can imagine the build quality between them is like so different. And instead for the SSD here, you have better airflow and better air ventilation for the intake for the APU. So we're going to check if it's going to cool it actually more. But here you have some metallic part. I'm not sure that this metallic material may cool down the Legion Go better, while here you have a 3D printed material. So, but before going any further, I want to show you that the SSD I'm going to use for the benchmarks as well as all tests, you will see before and after. I'm going to use the Legion Go SSD, the stock one that comes with it, as you can see. But I'm going to use the heatsink on top of it, along with a thermal pad, which is 1 millimeter thermal pad in between. So that's the kind of setups we are going to use for benchmarks. And also in the future, I'm going to make another video for an SSD 2080. So stick around for that one. Now let's install the kickstand for the mod case. So first of all, in order to install the kickstand, take away those parts, put it like this, just like originally. So we're good to go now. As you can see, stand is working well. As you can see, all 3 screws are here as well as in here. So we have pretty much good stability and it's also quite sturdy, so it's not like flimsy or light, so it can easily hold it up. I have no complaints with the hinge. It's pretty cool. So now for this one, it doesn't have any kind of plastics to get it so tight like the original one. As you can see, those parts are meant to make it so sealed. Instead, this one just has screws. You don't need to apply any kind of pressure, just put the holes in the right order. Okay, so we are good to go. Let's try out the kickstand. It works well. And here you can close this cover. Overall, we can see it has some airflow here for the SSD as well as for the APU. So it's going to allow for better airflow. And you could also install a dust mesh filter if you are concerned about the fans gathering more dust and debris since the holes are bigger. So yeah, you could consider that as well. You could definitely tell there's a difference in looks now, like the region goal looks totally different. For me personally, I prefer the original one. So with that being said, let's get over now to the test and check this one out. See you guys. So for testing this mod, we have on the left the Legion Go original cover and on the right the modded one. We'll start first with the 3DMark Time Spy at 30W TDP with 10 PM, along with a full fan speed. So the final score doesn't seem quite different, but still we got a minimal score boost to both GPU and CPU. To further confirm this, let's do a Time Spy stress test, which repeats the same scene over for 20 times to simulate a gaming scenario and stress all components during that time. And here are the results. We notice that the stress stability has increased by about 1% in the modded cover than the original one, which is actually a welcome change. But by looking at TEMPS, we see a very odd thing. For CPU with original cover, we had maximum temp of 82C, while with modded it got to 84. As for GPU, they are both similar at around 73. But the main highlight are the SSD temp, where we got two sensors. One for the controller, which is the first one, and the hotspot one is the NAND memory temp. So for controller, we got maximum of 66 with the original cover versus 72 with the modded one. That's 6 degrees more. And the NAND hotspot got higher by 7 degrees with the modded one. Not gonna lie, the moment I saw this, I got quite disappointed, because I was really expecting quite the opposite, given that the modded cover has some air vents around the SSD area. Like, how can we have worse temps? So I wanted to confirm this by doing a crystal disk benchmark. Let's see how it goes. Looking at the final result, we don't see quite a difference except for the Q1-T1 benchmark, which is a sequential type of test for the SSD. In that specific one, we see a significant drop in the speed, and it has dropped in both read and write. Now, I'm not exactly sure of this behavior, but when looking at the Gazelle temp, it may make more sense, because SSD temps has worsened by 3 degrees on the controller, and on the hotspot, it has reached this time 111 degrees Celsius, which is quite ridiculous if you ask me. Now, I know the original cover isn't any better, being at 108 degrees as well. They are both high to say the least, and such temps are pretty dangerous for the SSD over time and will probably cause those drives to fail faster than usual. But on the bright side for CPU, the modded cover has lowered temp by about 4 degrees for CPU and 3 for GPU. But now back to the SSD temp concern. What I believe the cause of the lower temp on the original one is for the fact that it has some metallic interior material that may conduct heat more efficiently off the surface than the 3D printed plastic one. So even though we have some air vents on the modded cover, but still it's trapping heat quite more. I could be wrong, so please correct me on that. Finally, let's do a real world case scenario by gaming for 30 minutes and see how high temps would reach on both covers over time. So after 30 minutes of gaming, at the end of test, for CPU with original cover we got about 74, while for the modded it has been lowered to 72. As for CPU, on original it's 72, while for modded it's 70. So we could say it has been lowered by 2 degrees for both CPU and GPU. But still, SSD controller temp has maxed out at 70 on the original one, while 73 on the modded one. And the NAND hotspot is 92 on the original, while 95 on the modded one. So the issue is still quite persistent even in gaming. Now during this gaming session, I took a thermal image of each cover, and we can see how heat is being distributed in a different way. On the original cover, the maximum hotspot, which is where the APU is located, is 80C, while on the modded one it's 77. But taking a close shot at the SSD area, we see on the original cover, hotspot is 59, which is right where the SSD is located, while for the modded one it's 70C. Now I'm not sure of this, but to me it's clear that heat is being distributed across bigger surface on the original cover, while in the modded one it's being trapped in one area, and that's causing our increased temp. Now after seeing those results, I personally can't wonder but asking, why would anyone get such a mod cover? Is it for the 2 degrees less on CPU or GPU, but at the cost of a dangerously higher SSD temp? Also, the modded cover has lower material quality and could get more dust inside the fan for not much of a benefit. But of course, if you are getting it mounted at 2280 NVMe on the exterior part, that may be a good idea. But if you were thinking to get it and put the SSD in its original place, then it's not going to serve you well. I personally find it quite odd to switch the original cover, which looks nicer, to a 3D printed one. Frankly saying, I'd rather wait for a well-designed cover addressing the increased SSD temp we have been seeing continuously on the Legion Go. Now someone should step up on this and make us the upgraded back cover for the Legion Go that it really deserves. Now I'll give this mod cover another chance and place a normal size 2280 SSD once my adapter arrives. Additionally, I'm also expecting more heat sinks to arrive for the 2242 SSD size, so don't miss out on that video once it's up. So that's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a like and subscribe to DecoSor to be updated on future videos. Thanks for watching and support, guys, and see you on the next one.